Let's get you all the updates on the big international story of the day. Donald Trump, US president, says the World Health Organization failed to prepare the world for this pandemic. Donald Trump blames the World Health Organization for being too China-centric. While Trump's own response is nothing to write home about, there is merit in the president's claims. Let's give you a detailed account of how the WHO failed to read the warning signals time and time again. It was on the 31st of December last year that China reported a new strain of the coronavirus to the World Health Organization country office. Chinese authorities referred to a seafood market in Wuhan as the focal point, but it was only in late February that the World Health Organization team was actually granted permission to visit Wuhan, that turned out to be the epicenter of this virus. For close to 2 months, the World Health Organization's response was based on the information that it was being published by the Chinese government, and this had consequences. On the 13th of January, the first case was reported outside China in Thailand. The patient had not visited the seafood market in Wuhan, but World Health Organization refused to believe this was a case of human-to-human transmission. They used a study conducted by China to reject this possibility. Experts argue that the exponential rise in the number of cases was a clear indication of human-to-human transmission. It was only on the 20th of January that China confirmed human-to-human transmission. Keep in mind that during this whole time, infected patients from China were making their way across the world, unaware that they were carriers of a deadly infection. On January 23rd, when China quarantined the entire city of Wuhan, it was obvious to the world that the situation was serious. But the World Health Organization was still dragging its feet. On the same day, the organization issued an intermediate level alert, despite the call for at least a public health emergency proclamation. That announcement came 7 days later, by which time it became clear that the Western countries would also be hit by this virus. United States was one of the first countries to impose travel curbs on China, but the World Health Organization interpreted this as racism, as a way of stigmatizing China. Interestingly, the same organization had called for travel curbs on SARS-hit countries back in 2002. Between the 16th and the 24th of February, the World Health Organization and China conducted a joint assessment of the situation. The report praised China for what it described as the most ambitious, agile, and aggressive containment response in history. But there was no mention of the massive underreporting of cases that has now come to light. Interestingly, the report also had a warning for the global community that the virus was highly contagious and could cause enormous health, economic, and social impacts. But the World Health Organization still refused to call it a pandemic. On the 26th of February, the World Health Organization Chief Tedros once again raised the stigma argument while rejecting the proclamation of a pandemic. By this point, there were more than 80,000 cases worldwide and 2,800 deaths. Finally, on the 11th of March, the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a pandemic. By this time, China had overcome the worst of this disease and Europe was bracing for the worst of it. The World Health Organization has a very simple mandate if you think about it. Keep an eye out for diseases that could ravage the world, advise governments on adequate responses, and keep politics out of it. But the WHO failed on all three counts. By trusting China, the WHO failed to warn us about how severe the outbreak was going to be. Most governments were left to devise a strategy on their own. China's lockdown method and South Korea's rampant testing method were not suggested by the World Health Organization, but devised by their own policy makers. And finally, the politicization. The World Health Organization ostracized Taiwan and refused to believe its reports as early as mid-December. And the World Health Organization chief was praised. He has praised China's response to the pandemic without ever casting a shadow of doubt over the numbers reported by the Chinese Communist Party.